I'm back. Welcome back to Couples Couch with
Pat,
and I'm Cam. This is a special event episode where we will take a flashback to visit one of the Married at First Sight Houston cast members to see what he has been up to since the show ended. So let's get into it. Ryan, welcome to Couples Couch.
How are y'all? I feel like I've been watching y'all for so long, and it's kind of intimidating to finally meet y'all.
Don't say that. We're so happy to have you here on the show. How have you been?
I've been good. Everything's starting to calm down. It's crazy. I guess this show just came out on Hulu to people. So I think we're all getting noticed more outside of Gil, because Gil gets noticed by everybody at all times.
Yeah.
But I think the lower tier of us are getting more noticed now that right. It's available on Hulu for everybody. So right. It's kind of cool. It's different for sure, but it's cool.
That's good. Well, we're super excited to catch up with you. We have a few questions. We just want to dive right into it to see what your thoughts are in this process of Married at First Sight. So first and foremost, we all want to know, do you still talk to Brett?
No, I don't talk to Brett anymore. I haven't talked to Brett, honestly, since decision day outside of the reunion. We no texts, no conversations or anything. Yeah, I think our stuff is official in 5 days. Not that I'm keeping track or anything,
but you're counting down.
About 5 days, let's say noon March 6th.
That's hilarious. Well, that's sad. I mean, I guess you guys aren't like cordial at all.
It's not sad.
Do you feel, or did you feel any kind of way about her exchanging numbers with that guy while you guys were still married on the show?
Yeah, we were in a tough spot, obviously. I think it was apparent to everybody. Yeah. I mean, Pat called it pretty much at the wedding that that we weren't gonna work. But yeah, it was tough, but we both knew where we were at that point. Mm-hmm. We knew we had to what we signed up for and our obligations, and at that point neither of us wanted to be where we were. Neither of us wanted to even continue what we were doing. But I mean, we were in it. So
in this season, we got to see the way not to do it. So
in Boston.
Yeah, that's been tough, man. And I actually have had people reach out to me apologizing that I handled it the way that I did, which is also refreshing to hear, because I did try to be as understanding about it and kind of protect Brett as much as I could as far as what's not happening in Boston right now.
Exactly.
But it's tough to watch.
It's hard to watch.
It makes great TV.
I say that too, though, in our review that, you know, a lot of the times you were really, you know, mute with a lot of your feelings because I felt like you were trying to protect her, you know, her feelings and not
absolutely. If I did nothing else, I wanted to be aware that this was a TV show and I was being seen and everything that I said and did at most times.
Yeah.
Even when we're just in our apartment, I mean,
everything's
for the most part is captured outside of the bathroom and in the bedroom. So yeah. I was aware at most points that everything that I said could and probably would be used if it made me look like that.
Exactly.
Right, but it didn't look like either one of you all were mean or you know, going after each other the way.
Yeah, and we were. I think we're both. I'm a respectable person. I know Brett is. She might say differently of me. But I think we handled it the best we could given the cards we were dealt, honestly.
Right. I always thought he handled it good, but I think this season he definitely got a level up on the good guy meter.
It's going to be, I mean, never say never, but it's going to be tough for somebody to beat what's happened in the Boston season, I feel like, in that pairing. But
somebody somewhere saying, hold my beer.
So San Diego said, hold my beer. That was not a challenge for any future
too late.
I want to know, did you ever go on a date with the girl that you were matched with on that dating app?
I don't even know who I'm matched with on the dating app, to be honest. Okay. And nobody's going to believe me on this, but I was never even swiping on there. I literally hit the iCloud button and then all these, hey, you relax. Let me at least get my talk, my speech up. I honestly, I might've been active the whole time. I just didn't know it. When Cal was at my house, he saw me delete this. I mean, it's on camera. I delete data. Yes.
Yes.
And I even showed the producers after the show and screenshotted a Brett. I mean, that made it on the reunion, thankfully. So maybe I got a little bit of belief from other people on that I did show her that I wasn't active and that I hadn't talked to anybody. And I didn't even have time to like cover my tracks at that point. I walked out. I literally packed my suitcase that night. It was funny because my producer was like, Ryan, you can't make moves like that. What, you can't make big moves like that off camera. I was like, we're done. I'm packing my stuff. And they had me actually bring a bag back to the apartment so I could do like the pack up.
Yeah, I saw that. And I remember Brett saying, like, what are you coming back here for?
Yeah, do you have anything left here to pack? All right.
Yeah, I guess I'll pack the salt and pepper.
It was a tough week, though. I mean, and it was so close to being done, but I feel like I would have been, I don't know, it kind of brought more to Brett and I's storyline, which was never the goal, but it did. So
make good TV, if not nothing else. I was like, ooh, he's on a whole dating app.
I'm glad that I could provide that for that brief moment for y'all.
Damn iCloud, they've got so many players in trouble.
So Ryan, in your opinion, why do you think you and Brett weren't compatible?
You'd think as many times as I've been asked that I'd have like a generic answer for it, but I really don't. We're very different. And not saying that she's not, we're just driven by different things. I'm motivated. I'm going to the gym every day. I'm always going to be doing investments and stuff through work. And I'm not saying, I don't know. We're very different as far as our day to day. I was kind of go, go, go. And one of the toughest things for me to hear was when she told me her ideal weekend was like Netflix and chill on the couch. And I'm like, that's never going to be for me. And not saying that's not the way to live, but that's just not me. And maybe I should do more of that, but
are you saying we shouldn't call you over to hang out because that's a lot of what we're doing here?
No, not unless there's outback or some kind of outing involved. I feel like that's awesome to have that in a relationship, but we were still trying to build our stuff.
Yeah, and you got a match. If I was, I don't really like to do anything. That's why I got an English bulldog. Like, my dog matches my temperament. Like, I'm always down.
Early on, you were into football before you broke your ACL or what is it?
You don't break it.
Oh, whatever.
I fractured my ACL.
Before you. Shut up, Ryan. I wasn't there, but early on in the relationship, like when we lived in DC, you know, Patrick did flag football at the Washington Monument. Every Sunday, was it? And I would go out there most Sundays, even though I'm not into football, and that would be like our thing to be out and kind of bond over different activities. Right. I wouldn't early on in the relationship try to say, let's bond over a Netflix movie. No, you know what I mean? Like, that's like if you're trying to do something else, but you know, different.
That's when I got my Netflix account.
Anyway, so I feel you. You do want to kind of, when you meet someone new, you want to be able to explore different activities with them.
Ryan, when someone asks you that question, just have them refer back to episode one of season, what was that, 14?
14 now.
And they can hear me say, he's just not that into her.
Yeah. Like, he said that 12 times.
I even said, she's a cute girl. Yeah. It's like, she's not attractive. But he's just not into
it. Yeah. He is. And I think I've said many times, like, she's attractive. I said on the wedding night, she's very attractive. And she is. We're just very different.
So what traits do you look for in a mate, I guess?
I need our day-to-days to line up more. Like, I want somebody to go work out with. I want somebody to go run at the park with the dogs. Like, I need that. Because it's so much wasted time, I feel like. Every day, if that's not something that somebody's interested in, and I mean, that adds up.
next.
Yeah.
And if you're really into your hobbies or you know, activities like that, and you can't share it with your other person,
right,
that distance is created on top of just everyday distance. So I get it.
Yeah.
And I feel like if I would have really pushed the issue, like, yeah, she would have probably came to the gym with me. Like, she probably would have done some of these things, but I don't want to make somebody do that, especially after this experience when you have to, I mean, the rest of your life is a long time. And
transforming everything else.
Yeah, exactly.
Do other things. So I get it. Since you've been through the married at first sight, you know, process, what is one piece of advice you would give the current cast members in the Boston season? For married at first sight,
I feel like I might get in trouble for saying this because it's been said so many times on season 14, but be a good person. Yeah. Be a really effing good person.
I love it. Yes.
I'm a really good person. If it doesn't come off like I'm a good person,
I'm gonna be pissed.
Yeah, and along with that, just like I said earlier, be aware. Like, you know this guy, you see this guy's wearing a phone on his, I mean, that's your producer and you trust your producer to an extent, but that's their job. They're going to get content and you're providing them a lot of content.
Exactly. And don't say one thing in one scene and say something else that contradicts that completely, because
hey, there's a few people on season 14 doing that though, to be fair.
Yeah, I know. Yeah. That's true. Not just the one good person.
Y'all can call them contradictions. They're straight lies.
Yeah.
And it's editing is like calling them out on it too, and it's just shady.
Whoever's editing, watch like Chappelle's show, because it seems like, oh, I didn't do that to a kid.
I'm not gonna give examples because I don't want anybody on that season hating me, but yeah, there's been several.
We've all seen it. And all the viewers watching right now know exactly what we're referencing to.
Perfect.
So are you dating right now at all?
I actually just got downloaded the dating app 2 weeks ago for the actual usage of the dating app this time. It's a lot more carefree at this point where I'm not going to get in trouble for it. But yeah, I really haven't dated at all because, I mean, there's such a long period. I mean, it's twice as long as you're actually married on the show that you have to portray being married. Like, I couldn't be out dating. I couldn't be out running around acting like a dipshit. Like, I had to be present, like, as the show was going. Yeah, it was tough adapting to that. And I'm actively trying to date at this point. I'm going out more. I think last week I've hung out with, I mean, I hung out with three of the cast members last week. Like, we go out. I got Gil to go out with me. He had more success than me, obviously. That night we went out.
Gil, so check in on Gil. Gil is okay?
Gil's
good?
Gil's living his best life. He couldn't be doing better right now.
I knew Gil was going to be
good. Gil is doing good. Everybody, you don't have to be concerned about Gil. If y'all want to keep sending stuff to his P.O. box, he appreciates it.
Gil's built for the streets. Gil could be all right. We got to get Gil on
here. In the streets. Tell Gil that he is a friend to the show and he definitely needs to come on here and let us hear from
him. I will definitely tell him that.
Yeah, that would be great.
You're out there putting out fires.
Ryan, I thank you so much for taking time out of your super busy schedule to join us
here. I have one quick question.
Oh, shit.
Did you attend Jose's financial literacy class? Did he break out the whiteboard on you?
I can't talk financials with that guy anymore. It's a lot. I love the kid, but yeah, we're not going to talk stocks and stuff anytime soon. He's awesome too. He's dating again. And yeah, everybody's doing good. It's such a low, and I don't want to speak. Show was awesome. It was a great experience, but it takes a toll on you, man, especially like Johnny and Bao, and everybody gets their kind of share of it. And it's tough. Yeah. It's tough being in our position. It's knowing that we're going to get the backlash that we're inevitably going to get. We're kind of expected to make these relationships work, and we don't have a lot to like fall back on with it. And it's just, it's tough for viewers to put themselves in that position because everybody's like, oh, he didn't even try. Like, it's a marriage. And yeah, it's a marriage. Marriage is a huge thing, but we don't have the stories that put us where we are with this person. Like, it's just, boom, you're married.
You don't have any.
You got to spend all this time with the girl you first met at the club that you usually be like, yo, you want some to drink? And bounce and never come back. Like, now you got to make it work.
The marriage word makes people think that they have to stick it out no matter what. And that's, I mean, that's not fair to us. And
marriage is
everybody that I can say for sure. I'm not going to say I can say for sure, but I think everybody definitely on our season had the right intentions. We all wanted it to work. I mean, we're obviously the older group of people that they've casted for this. And I think they did that for a reason. They wanted people that were serious about the marriage and they did find people that were serious about the marriage. It just didn't happen for us.
And you were saying earlier that you have to, I guess, kind of stay in a bubble while this show is airing. So you kind of get to watch it in, I guess, real time with the rest of us because you're not really interacting. Did you or any of your other castmates kind of look back on some of their actions?
Oh, yeah.
Or
see, I felt okay about my actions until the end. But yeah, I think a lot of people definitely reflected on that. I know it was tough for Johnny to watch some of it. It was tough for a lot of us to watch parts of it. Nobody made out of it. What was that?
Zach probably the crying and the boohoo falling and the
I've got Gil to come to my gym once. I've got Jose to come once. Zach's came once, and everybody kind of does their own thing. I've tried to incorporate everybody to work out together, but it's not happening.
Johnny got to get in the gym three times a day at Baskin Robbins.
Hey, I got an update on Johnny's weight today. Actually, he told me he's back up to 159. He dropped like 130 on the show. He was going through it. He lost a lot of weight on the show, but
I never got there. Kamar asked me when we first started dating, "Have you ever been in a relationship it went bad and you couldn't eat?" Two got nothing to do with each other. No.
He's like, I'm still eating. Well, Ryan, we really, really thank you for taking time out of your super busy schedule to join us here at Couples Couch. I'm so thankful that you had the time to do this with us.
No, and I'm thankful. I mean, I feel like I'm a fan of y'all's. I've been watching and commenting and bantering with you and Pat throughout the season, and I miss doing that. I wish y'all could do more of these, and I wish you could do it like real time. That'd be a cool thing, but I know it's tough with what we're allowed to do and getting approvals and all that. Yeah. But no, I'm glad that y'all made the time for me as well.
Yeah, anytime. You're definitely
next time you're in Dallas, we'll go to an Outback.
Perfect. I'll check my schedule. I would love that.
We'll hold you to it. And again, thank you for joining us. And to everyone out there, thank you so much for watching. Please be sure to drop your comment in the comment section below. Ask Ryan some questions that he is able to answer. He will ping you back in the comment section.
Oh, you know I'm in there.
So drop your comments below. We would love to hear from you. And please be sure to hit the like and the subscribe button to support our channel. Again, we thank you guys for watching, and we will see you in the next video.
Bye,
everyone. Bye, Ryan.